So after taking both the Xiaomi Mi 11 Ultra and the Samsung Galaxy S21 Ultra for quite a ride against each other, it is finally time to unveil which phone is truly the Ultra smartphone. Hey guys, Adam Lobo here from Adam Lobo TV, and in this video, I will compare the hardware, the displays, the cameras, audio, battery, software, gaming, and giving you the conclusion on which phone is better or worth your money. Now, starting from the phone's hardware, from a design and build. Saying this is based on a personal preference may seem like I'm copping out, but I can tell you that I'm not. As there is the matte glass finish on the S21 Ultra with quite a solid build and weight to the phone, and surely the current best looking smartphone that Samsung has ever created thus far. And then there's also the Mi 11 Ultra, which is Xiaomi's most extreme smartphone design with a slightly heavier weight, with a glossy ceramic finish at the back. And who could not notice the huge camera bump, which you could see it from outer space? Maybe not. But jokes aside, I actually personally like the camera bump, where just like what Samsung has done, Xiaomi embraces the camera bump to make it a statement piece on the phone. And the good news is that when it comes to typing both phones on a surface, it was totally fine as it didn't wobble at all. Now, in terms of dimensions, it is almost the same, where the S21 Ultra is just a tad bit bigger. Then as for the ports and buttons, what's interesting is that both phones had the same placement for the volume and the power button, which is on the right, and everything was the same down below. But what really separates the phone is of course the Mi 11 Ultra's IR blaster, and the other stereo speaker is placed on top instead of the S21 Ultra being placed at the earpiece area. So yes, we shall see how does this translate to the overall sound quality when we do a sound test later. Now, as for the phone screen's panel, both has the same toughest Corning Gorilla Glass Victus. And speaking of the front panel, in terms of which phone unlocks faster, the Ultra surely unlocks faster, but I kind of suspect why the Mi 11 Ultra is a bit slower is because of the unnecessary animation on the phone. While I did mention that this is a personal preference, if I had to absolutely choose, I would go with the Mi 11 Ultra. Why? Because of its glossier ceramic finish at the back, as it will be less prone to scratches, where I've accidentally scratched the S21 Ultra when I was mounting it on my phone comparison rig. And of course, while y'all might have known that I'm a fan of the white color too. Now, as for the phone's display, both phones comes with an AMOLED panel, where Samsung has named their display the Dynamic AMOLED 2x display with the same resolution of 1440 by 3200 pixels and a 120Hz refresh rate. Now, the first thing that I've noticed is that the S21 Ultra surely gets really bright when it's adjusted to the maximum, where what's funny is that according to paper, the Mi 11 Ultra is supposed to be having a higher peak brightness, but that was not the case when you compare both phones from side to side. And many don't actually see this as something worth mentioning, that I always found that Samsung screen has always the right amount of brightness depending on the environment, thanks to their better adaptive display, which I felt it adjusted well, whether it's dark or even on a bright area, where it does a better job overall compared to the Mi 11 Ultra. And yes, I did experience a screen dimming issue when I was taking photos and videos during the comparison video on the Mi 11 Ultra, but again, it's not too extreme where you couldn't see the screen at all. So if I really had to choose when it comes to the phone's display because of its brighter screen and the overall display performance from a software's perspective, I would go with the S21 Ultra. And yes, I am aware of the tiny screen at the back of the Mi 11 Ultra, although it is cool to have that, but ask yourself, how many times are you actually gonna put your phone face down? I don't. Do you? Let me know at the comment section below. Now, before I compare the images and the video quality for both phones, let's first check out the specs. Now, the Mi 11 Ultra comes with a 50 megapixel f2.0 lens, a 48 megapixel f4.1 periscope lens with 5x optical zoom, and a 48 megapixel f2.2 12mm ultra wide angle lens. Then as for the S21 Ultra, it has a massive 108 megapixel f1.8 aperture lens, a 10 megapixel periscope lens, but up to 10x optical zoom instead, Then there's a 10 megapixel f2.4 telephoto lens and a 12 megapixel f2.2 13mm ultra-wide angle lens. Now starting from the high megapixel mode, although the S21 Ultra has a bigger megapixel mode, there's not much of a difference if you take a shot before zooming in. But when you're zooming close, the S21 Ultra just had a bit more detail compared to the Mi 11 Ultra. Not too far off, to be honest. Next, looking at the main lens, images again look very close to each other, where the only difference is the sky area, where it was a bit bluer on the S21 Ultra, but the colors of the roof and building was very similar on this image. But what's interesting is that in this image instead, it was a total opposite, where the sky area seems to be a bit more bluish on the Mi 11 Ultra instead, and a tiny bit cooler tone on the Mi 11 Ultra, but the details on both were the same. Now, as for the phone's zooming mode, although there is an advantage of the S21 Ultra to have a dedicated telephoto lens, the Mi 11 Ultra still does a pretty good job when it comes to its periscope lens. Keeping up, although it has half the optical zoom capabilities of the S21 Ultra. But if you guys are looking to zoom very far, although I have no idea who in a right frame of mind would zoom all the way to 120 times, but if you compare side by side, although the S21 Ultra can go up to 100 times zoom instead of 120, since there is the zoom lock feature to hold a viewfinder on the subject, it is easier to take photos on the S21 Ultra, where you can even get better clarity at that. So personally, I don't get why in the world that Xiaomi would be extremely proud with the whole 120 times zoom, where the images look super unusable, which Samsung has learned to move away from that branding since the S20 Ultra. And speaking of Ultra, let's look at the ultra wide angle lens, where the overall image quality looks pretty much the same, but the Mi 11 Ultra has a wider focal length, so you get a bit more into your shot. Now in this second picture, the difference is that the S21 Ultra has just a bit warmer tone, a bit more true to life as how the building actually was, and the AI processing on the Mi 11 Ultra this time made the photos look a bit more saturated as seen at the blue sky area again. So this does come down to a personal preference, which I prefer the image on the S21 Ultra, but I do appreciate the wider focal length that you can get on the Mi 11 Ultra. Now as for the portrait mode for subjects, both phones had mixed results, where there were times where the Mi 11 Ultra was better on the edge detection and there were times where the S21 Ultra was better. But when it comes to human subjects, the edge detection and the background blur was equally as good for both phones, but the shadows are a bit more apparent on the Mi 11 Ultra and a bit more crushed blacks as opposed to the S21 Ultra, which had a more true-to-life color, as the t-shirt that I was wearing was not as black as how the Mi 11 Ultra was, so this again has to come down to a personal preference. Now as for night mode, once again, due to the higher megapixel count, the Mi 11 Ultra has better details on the edges, but in terms of the highlights and shadows, both were the same as how a flagship smartphone quality would be. Then they were very identical for the main lens at the same area of shots. But when it comes to taking photos in a very poorly lit area, the 100 megapixel main lens on the S21 Ultra starts to show, not only because it's slightly brighter, but also more detail on the floor and the pillar on the right. And lastly, when it comes to taking a shot with a scenario with night lights, the glare coming from the S21 Ultra from the lights seems to be a bit better compared to the Mi 11 Ultra. Then looking at the front camera, the Mi 11 Ultra has a 20 megapixel f2.2 aperture and the S21 Ultra has a 40 megapixel f2.2 aperture lens. Okay, so here is where there was not a little but a huge difference in quality for both of the phones. Where starting from the regular selfie, there was never a point where I could not get the background to overexpose in this picture comparison was the best that I could get from the Mi 11 Ultra, which looks just bad compared to the S21 Ultra. Then the results were even worse for the portrait selfie mode, where I posted this image on my Instagram stories and there were three people who joked and said that Xiaomi has cut off my hair, which as you guys can see, looks pretty much true. Then to combat this issue, I tried the rear screen selfie to use the rear camera with that tiny viewfinder at the back, and still the images look like this. And also worth mentioning, this rear display selfie is only used for the regular photo mode but not the portrait mode, and also no video recording mode as well. But the good news is that the night selfie shots were better but still cannot get close to the image quality that the S21 Ultra offers. Now as for video, both can record up to a massive 8K resolution at 24 frames per second, where here I felt that Xiaomi has redeemed themselves by having a better 8K recording with a better image stabilization compared to the S21 Ultra, where it was just a tad bit jittery looking through the phone's viewfinder and also in the footage as well. But still, very much usable footage if you guys are recording in that resolution. 4K video on both were equally as good for the ultra wide angle lens and also the main lens as well. Then super steady mode on the S21 Ultra was as gimbal-like as usual, but the 1080p rear video wasn't a night and day difference when it comes to the overall image stabilization compared to the 1080p footage when I was using on the Mi 11 Ultra. Then I tested some nighttime video, and here's where, although both phones had a great image stabilization, but the image tends to fall apart with every step taken on the Xiaomi Mi 11 Ultra, as you guys can see over here. Then as for the front video recording, while the S21 Ultra can record up to 4K 60 frames per second, the Mi 11 Ultra, yet again, only gives us up to 1080p up to 60 frames per second. I mean, which year is it? Now, as you guys can see, that not only the video resolution on the Mi 11 Ultra doesn't come close to what the S21 Ultra offers, but the camera doesn't seem to understand what they're doing with the exposure, where it seems to be contemplating what to expose, like, oh, let's expose the subject, oh, let's expose the background, as seen in this video footage. So overall, when it comes to the phone's camera's performance, you can see that the rear cameras are great and quite similar for both of the phones, but when it comes to the front camera, I'm sure you would agree with me that the S21 Ultra performs way much better. Now, in terms of audio, when it comes to both phone speakers, they both have stereo speakers, so there wasn't a huge sound quality difference. And just so you all know that the Mi 11 Ultra is tuned by Harman Kardon, a company that Samsung owns, in case you guys do not know. But the S21 Ultra is tuned by AKG. Now, in terms of sound output, the Mi 11 Ultra beats the S21 Ultra with a higher dB value of 96 compared to 94.1 on the S21 Ultra. And then in terms of sound quality, it is great to know that this whole tune by Harman Kardon surely gives a difference when it comes to the overall audio quality. Because not only the phone was louder, but the overall clarity when it comes to the vocals and also the mids were surely better on the Mi 11 Ultra. Now, as for the phone's battery, both has the same battery capacity of 5000 mAh of battery, and using both phones separately daily, the S21 Ultra got me a whooping 6 hours and 39 minutes at WQHD+ resolution, with the adaptive refresh rate turned on at 10% battery, and also with dark mode on. And the Mi 11 Ultra not only drained the battery very quickly after it reached the 50% mark, but it got me an average of 3.5 hours of screen on time when I was at 9 or 10% battery with the very same settings. Now, this I believe could be because of its better adaptive display and of course the software battery optimization that the One UI has compared to the Mi UI. However, where the Mi 11 does better is of course through the massive 67W fast charging and another 67W fast wireless charging, which was quite mind-blowing compared to Samsung only being able to charge up to 25W fast charging and 15W wireless charging. And of course, worth mentioning is the fact that the 65W charging brick does come inside of the box for the Mi 11 Ultra, where the Samsung S21 Ultra was the first smartphone from Samsung which did not have a charging brick. So this does come down to what type of a smartphone user that you are to know which is better for you, where if you're the kind of person who charges the phone overnight and prefers to only charge the phone once a day, then the S21 Ultra would be the phone for you. But if you're the kind of person who prefers not to charge your phone overnight to save battery life by charging it only when you wake up, to make use of the fast charging option, then the Mi 11 Ultra should be your choice. Now, as for software, the overall experience as of making of this video, the Mi 11 Ultra is currently using the version 12.0.1.0 and the S21 Ultra is using the One UI version 3.1. Now, for this, I'm not gonna beat around the bush or cop out of this too, as I'm gonna tell you straight to the point that I prefer how the One UI version 3.1 was. Because we've seen how much Samsung has evolved starting from their old Samsung experience compared to what it is today for their way better One UI version 3.1, where they have improved drastically with better software optimization for apps and currently is the only smartphone which is not an iPhone that has no compression when it comes to posting videos and photos on Instagram as well. Now, navigating through the menu and settings are also easier compared to the not so straightforward of the MIUI 12, where for example, when I was trying to access the rear screen that I was talking about, instead of maybe putting it under the main display settings, you'll need to go to special features and then rear display instead. Why? I don't know. Then the dark mode integration on the Mi 11 Ultra is still not great, where apps like YouTube Studio, you cannot see the icons for the comments, likes or love. And it is the same when it comes to Canva, and it looks very weird on Facebook as well. But the light at the end of the tunnel is that the way cheaper Poco F3 has already gotten the MIUI version 12.0.5.0, which does solve all the dark mode issues, which I think is a time for a revamp of the UI, as I mentioned in my 1 month review of the Poco F3, if you guys haven't checked it out. So that's my take on comparing both of the phone software. And also worth mentioning is that the Mi 11 Ultra Snapdragon 888 chipset seriously overheats like crazy. Even when I was watching videos or a bit of heavier apps and multitasking, where the S21 Ultra's Exynos 2100 seems to run cool and just a tiny bit warm to the touch, no matter what you throw at it. And speaking of apps and multitasking, although both phones has UFS 3.1 storage, the USB port on the Mi 11 Ultra has a slower version 2.0. And the S21 Ultra has a faster speed of USB 3.2, so the S21 Ultra gives you a faster transfer speed when it comes to copying files via the USB-C port. When it comes to playing games on both phones, we tested Genshin Impact. First, when it comes to the S21 Ultra, it was adjusted to the highest settings with motion blur turned off, and it ran smoothly without any issues for the first 10 minutes. But right after that, we did experience some small frame rate drops, but it did not really affect the overall experience, and the phone did get a bit warm to the touch. Then when it comes to gaming on the Mi 11 Ultra on the similar settings, the graphic quality and the frame rate overall was better compared to the S21 Ultra, but the phone was again extremely hot, about 10 minutes or so, and there was a severe battery drain right after that. So if I had to choose between both phones when it comes to gaming, I obviously prefer the S21 Ultra, even though I'm not much of a gamer. But yes, keep in mind for those of you who game a lot on a smartphone. Alright, that's my review and my overall comparison for both phones. And as a conclusion, I would say this. While I know that I might be upsetting some Mi 11 Ultra users in this video, I honestly feel like I need to give my feedback to help you make a purchase decision, because I felt that Xiaomi rushed too quickly to get this phone out and should have taken their time to release a potential beast of a phone or just stuck to their non-Ultra Mi 11 as their best. Yes, there were some great things about the phone, especially with a very impressive spec sheet and a very good set of cameras, especially for the rear, but it also comes with a not so good software experience, and the overheating issues almost makes the phone a jack of all trades and a master of few. But who cares what I think? What matters most is what you guys think. So let me know which phone that you guys would choose at the comment section below, and if the S21 Ultra is worth the extra money. Let's discuss down at the comment section below.